Hey, so today's bit of news from Games Workshop. Again, as I said the other day, I'm gonna start treating the Games Workshop stories as more of a news show in terms of what we're doing. We're gonna be doing lots and lots and lots and lots of advice and obviously stories from Games Workshop. And sometimes I will intersperse the stories with a bit of news and when I think it's pertinent to do so. This week we have had a bit of news on Games Workshop stock price. I've been asked about this a lot, and so I thought I would actually come on and give you guys a little bit of a thought process and what my feelings are towards the stock price. So, number one, I'm going to show you the stock price. Let me just head over to it now. So, as you can see here, we've seen quite a level decline over the past couple of months. Since June. So June hit a high up here. We're looking at what, a 17,190 in terms of the overall stock price. And we see it changing as we are falling up and down, up and down, falling away, falling away, falling away. And we're down something like 25 to 27% of Games Workshop's local stock since its height earlier this year. As you can see from the dates, it's really starts around the late June, early July, and I think you look back at my channel for a sort of barometer, that's around about the time when I was releasing videos on how ridiculous Games Workshop's copyright claims are being and how they are damaging the hobby and damaging the hobbyists who they have. I still hold to that. I still think that the actual practices in going after their own fan base and making sure that they can't release content that is the most sincere form of flattery to Games Workshop's overall worlds is a slap in the face to everybody who's ever given them a cent or penny of money. And I think the stock price is reflecting that. Now, what I will say is, if the stock price. I am not an alarmist, and so I'm not going to sit here and say Games Workshop is finished. I have seen so many YouTube channels come out and, you know, I love to use the phrase rend their garments. They've come out and they're like pulling at their clothes. Oh my god, it's over, it's the end times, they're finished, they're done now, they're not gonna do anything. No, don't be so fucking stupid, right? If you've been paying attention to the news, before we even go anywhere else, we probably have another lockdown on the way at some point. You know, touch wood doesn't happen, but you know, we probably got one on the way at some point. Which will only see Games Workshop stock rise even higher than it is now, or than it did earlier on this year. But even taking that out of the equation, Games Workshop is not a company that's going to go anywhere. It's not a company that's going to be raked over the coals. It's not a company that's going to lose any sort of momentum in terms of financial well-being. They make too much money to do that. They make too much money hand over fist to do that. I don't care what anyone says about the casting process. I don't care what anybody says about the paying staff members. I don't care what anybody says about keeping the lights on in certain stores. Each single Games Workshop product sells around a 450 to 500% profit margin. If you can't run a company well, earning that kind of money, then you don't deserve to be in business, quite simply. A £35 box of Space Marine Intercessors is making a ridiculous percentage of profit per item, right? That just is a fact. There's no getting around that. Okay, the actual contents of that box is worth around £5 to £7, and that's if you're really pushing on what the value of the contents of the box actually are. And so you are selling it at a what is that, 200, 300%, 400% profit. I mean, you know. Don't be coming at me saying that Games Workshop are about to go out of business. They are still selling tons of models. What we're seeing here, in my opinion, is exactly that. It's a loss of opinion. Same thing happened to CD Projekt Red. I would actually say CD Projekt Red are in a much bigger financial shitstorm position than Games Workshop are, right? And they're making, you know, the size of the companies aren't even comparable, right? But, you know, looking at how lambasted they've been in the press. And they're still doing fine. Like CD Projekt Red are still doing quite fine financially, right? Games Workshop are not going anywhere. So I just wanted to get that out the way right here, right now. do not listen to the alarmists. Do not listen to the people who are telling you that they're winning some sort of war against Games Workshop. If there is one, that's very sad. It's a company. Call them to task, sure, but, you know, just fucking get on with your lives. Stop being so dramatic. Games Workshop are not going anywhere. Financially or otherwise, they're not going anywhere, right? So, let's now examine the reasons why the stock price has tanked to the amount that it has been doing. Okay, so, this from Barney Inns Comics. It's a website I quite like. I've used them quite a few times before, going over certain things. And this is a story from a couple of days ago. I'm going to read some of it. Not all of it, obviously. What the fuck's that? Oh well. I'm going to read some of it. So Games Workshop has become the latest major entity to learn that abandoning its core fan base in favour of chasing profit and wide appeal never results in the success social media engagement would have them believe. Thank God somebody wrote that. God bless you. Who wrote this? Spencer Bakuli? Well done, my friend. Let me just put him on here. Who's this guy? What a guy. What a lovely thing. A lovely bit of prose there. Look at that. Brilliant. Right. The once-loved tabletop gaming company has apparently seen a massive drop in stock price ever since it engaged in a mass DMCA campaign against Warhammer Fanworks in order to promote the mass consumption-approved content featured on their official Warhammer Plus subscription service. Now, what I will say, the people who are doomsday saying about Warhammer Plus are completely right. That is something that will die a death very quickly. Warhammer does not have the pull. It does not have the amount of people interested in paying the money for it to pay for a subscription service. It doesn't. It just doesn't, right? And even if it did, the content that is on there is quite frankly kind of insulting right now. It's terrible, okay? Right. Let's rewind, right? Games Workshop seem to think that they're Marvel at this point in time. They're not, right? And Warhammer is a niche hobby, and they're trying to market a niche hobby like it's some sort of zeitgeist product that is out there like Marvel, like DC. It isn't. It just isn't, right? I'm sorry, it isn't. So, what we're seeing now is Warhammer Plus. The subscription numbers are dwindling. The subscription numbers are tanking. They're going down day by day. People are not signing up to it in their droves, if that is a saying that I can actually say makes sense. What they have done is they have neutered one of their best marketing ploys to try and make everything in-house and then not made anything in-house that's of any relevance or worth whatsoever. These are modern companies, ladies and gentlemen. These are companies in the modern day. They want everything for giving nothing, essentially. And if you bought your Warhammer subscription and you're enjoying it, all power to you, you know. According to a report by UK-based investment news outlet Investment Week via UK Today News, the ever-growing resentment of fans towards the company's tightening grip on its much-loved portfolio of characters and stories has resulted in Games Workshop's share price falling more than 25%. Right. I would take issue with that. Right? Games Workshop tightening their grip on their own IP makes fans seem unreasonable. We're not being unreasonable. We're not being unreasonable at all. Eisenhorn, stop moving around, please. You're distracting me. Right? We're not being unreasonable. Stealing a character from another piece of fiction, i.e. Berserk, i.e. Griffith, porting him into your own setting verbatim, calling him by a different name, and slapping a price tag on it, that's wrong. That's wrong. Oh, Bruce Buffer. That's wrong. Okay? Being very protective of your own IP, that's not wrong. It's your intellectual property. You're more than happy to... You were more than happy with you doing that, Games Workshop. That's not the problem. And this is the story that's being touted out there in media, as we're seeing, right? Okay? That somehow them being protective of their IP is what we're against. No, that's not what we're against. We're against hypocrisy of the highest order, right? We're against people who pull others into our hobby. We're against them being demonized and shut down. because you want to take the hobby and take the background and take everything that, that we like about it and neuter it down to the lowest common denominator. That's what we have a problem with. Nothing else. Nothing else. Right? You want to make it more diverse? Have at it. We will always have the old lore, right? Have at it. Whatever, dude. You do what you want to do. It's your IP. But do not stop us from enjoying it in the way that we like. Okay? Go fuck yourself. If I want to go and watch Emperor's a Texas Speech Device, if I want to go and watch Flash Gits, then I will. And I'll enjoy the hobby that way. And do you know what? Do you know what that results in? Me buying more of your fucking models. That's what it results in. I buy more of your fucking models. Fuck yourself. Anyway, bafflingly though, admittedly unsurprisingly, financial experts have all but dismissed the fans' role in Games Workshop's rapid devaluation. With SVM UK Growth and UK Emerging Funds Manager Margaret Lawson even asserting that she did not foresee any impact from a boycott and that falling stock prices were the wrong reaction. Explain, please. There is often a tension between franchises and fans, she says, which becomes more acute as the value of IP grows and a brand is extended online and into other partnerships. I'm going to say this but once. Warhammer has not become more popular over the last month, over the last year or two. It's not. It's not grown. I'm telling you that now. Warhammer has not become more popular by getting more fans over the last year or two. What it has done is add a captive audience. It's had people who are desperate to have an outlet in these troubled times turn to Games Workshop and give them their money because we are long-term hobbyists and we are keeping the fucking lights on. That's what we're doing. Right? If you're working in Nottingham, you get to go to work every day because people like me and the people watching this video and the people going into Games Workshop stores and trade accounts every single day, they're paying money for your overpriced models, right? The hobby itself, and this is something that can't really be measured. The only way I could measure it is to look at the KPIs in the stores and look at how many, you know, start collecting boxes they're selling and how many, you know, new player stuff things they're selling. But even then, that's a terrible barometer because a lot of old school hobbyists buy those boxes because they're good value. Good value, quote unquote, when Games Workshop makes all the prices up. But I'm telling you now, right, from somebody who runs a channel that is 90% to do with Warhammer, that organically grew into that. My channel organically grew into being more about Games Workshop and Warhammer than anything else, which is fine by me because I love it, right? And I never thought I'd get the opportunity or have the luck to produce work in this sphere because we have so many good YouTubers already. But luckily, the people of YouTube have taken pity on me and sort of taken me under their wing and said, hey, we'll give you some subs and we'll give you some views and hey, here's £50 here and £50 there to keep the lights on, thank you, right? I can tell you now, the hobby isn't growing. The sheer amount of people that I have in Discord and I have commenting on these videos will tell you. Out of 10 people, I'd say one is a new customer, is a new hobbyist, right? Those aren't the people who are driving your profits. Those aren't the people who are telling you, who are driving what your company is worth. The new people are not those people. And welcome to the hobby, by the way, because you will become those people. You will become one of us. The veterans who are keeping the fucking lights on. And it really pisses me off when I see articles, not articles at this, but people who are quoted in articles at this, who belittle the hobbyists and the role we have in making sure that Games Workshop are held accountable for what they do. Right? So, before complimenting the company's philosophy, I'm down here, by the way. Before complimenting the company's philosophy of out with the old and in with the new in regards to their fans, Games Workshop is going through this stage of evolution, which inevitably means a need for stronger IP control and disappointment for some. Right. Another bit of this frankly despotic, ridiculous statement that I wanna just pull apart. Out with the old and in with the new. Well, I will tell you now, again, as somebody who runs a community, which is, again, 90% focused on Warhammer and people who are very, 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 very positively inclined, I speak to hundreds of people a week about Warhammer, about Games Workshop, right? Out with the old and in with the new is a load of bollocks, right? Because the new people coming in have just the same mindset as the people who are already here. Do you know why? Because we're fucking Warhammer fans. That's why. Because we're all in this hobby because we love it. We're all in this hobby because we think the same way. We like the same things. You're not attracting a new breed of people into the hobby. You're killing it. You're killing it. You're taking the hobby away from the people who built the fucking place. We built this house. We built this house. We keep the lights on. Right? New blood is great. And if you've ever thought about getting into Warhammer 40,000, or Warhammer, or even Age of Sigmar, I implore you, get involved. Talk to me. The Discord is in the description. Come and talk to me about how cool the hobby is. Come and talk to Viorp or Oasis or anybody in the Discord. They will tell you how fucking cool the hobby is, right? It's amazing. It's a fantastic community to be involved in. And if people like this are now pulling it apart and saying that hobbyists are the problem, out with the old, in with the new, fuck those people. Because Warhammer's never going to go anywhere. And I'm telling you why. Because neither are we. Because the second we do, this house collapses. I don't give a fuck what people say. The minute we do, then this, that I was showing you before, when I was saying, yeah, there's no reason to panic just yet. You know, Games Workshop isn't going anywhere as a financial entity. Well, I'm telling you now, if this is the attitude that investors and investment bankers and people who are making sure that the Games Workshop are these are the people, if these are the people that Games Workshop are beholden to, analysts in the industry who are telling them how to run their company, how to make sure that their stock price goes up again, if this is the advice that they're receiving, the company will not be here in 10 years. There's no need to panic just yet. I'm not saying press the panic button. I'm just saying make a mental note of where the panic button is for future notice. That's all. Right? As noted today by UK News, fellow analyst Abby Glennie, the deputy head of a smaller company, investment company, agreed the move was a sensible one, that a loyal customer base with a passion for the hobby is unlikely to be disrupted by a boycott, she believes is implied by the media and in reality very limited in nature. Okay. So, Glennie also noted that the excellent management team has pushed the business forwards over recent years, particularly in relation to the very high margin and return business of licensing its IP across a range of formats, including video games, novels, and television shows. So, you tell me, as a Warhammer fan, whether Abby Glennie here is talking out of her fucking arse, right? Very high margin and return business of license. They've done very well at licensing their IP, have they? Have they indeed? Look on Steam and type in Warhammer. How many of those games have a positive reception? Not many. Right? Not many. The reason why companies make money with games like this is because they pay the people who make them buttons. Buttons. And haven't been any fucking television shows on HBO or Netflix or whatever to do with Warhammer. There should be. I need to get Henry Cavill onto that, to be honest with you. I'll give him a call. I'm joking, I don't know Henry Cavill. Anyway, however, not everyone who spoke to Investment Week underestimated the potential of a passionate and dedicated fan base. Oh, thank God for that, thank you. As senior investment and market analyst at Hargreaves Lansdown, Susanna Streeter said, recognised that fan sites can be the lifeblood of a brand. Somebody with a brain thank you. Although it is understandable that the company wants to protect its IP from scammers replicating its miniatures using 3D printers. Scammers. Games Workshop appears to have upset a diehard fan base by cracking down on amateur animations as well. Yes, Streeter explained. We have seen before how tips and advice can spread like wildfire through social media. So the growing clamour on sites like Reddit for a boycott of the company risks being the tip of the iceberg of problems for Games Workshop. Indeed it is. We are the silent majority. Okay? We are the silent majority. We don't go out there whinging and moaning. Most of us don't. He says as he makes a video about Warhammer whinging and moaning. But I said most of us don't. That's why you're watching me and I'm doing the talking, right? I'm doing the whinging. You guys are doing the yes, we agree. Or some of you are going, no, I don't agree. You're a retard, right? But we are a silent majority for the most part. We just vote with our wallets. We say, do you know what? Maybe Warhammer isn't for me this Christmas. Maybe all this virtue signaling that they're doing, maybe they don't want me in the hobby. Does it make me a Nazi or a Nazi sympathizer? No. Does it mean I don't like being talked down to by a company that sells stupid little plastic miniatures at really overpriced prices? Yes. Yes. I'm not a fan of being talked down to. Especially when I know some of the idiots who work there. Right? Who listen to things like this. Okay? Games Workshop's full of great people. And those people will not want you to be talked down to, trust me. Trust me. Unfortunately, it's the people at the very top of this thing who are pushing this down our throats. Right. Okay. YouTuber Arch commented on the stock decline, declaring Arch was right again, and inevitably, unavoidably, and now the world is slowly but surely catching up to me. Well, that's something Arch would say, to be fair. As Games Workshop is indeed in the early stages of monetizing its IP, and what does that mean? That means that Games Workshop is ready to get rid of you. They are trying to replace the fan base with the new glorious and hitherto unknown wider audience. That's definitely an Arch sentence. Because there was at least two words in there that I had difficulty pronouncing that just flowed out of his mouth. Right. The YouTuber added, the horde of wokest normies are right out there, ready to consume Games Workshop products on hitherto unknown and unimaginable quantity. Okay, so he then questioned, how is that working out so far? Well, the company's managed to shed 25% of its value, so I'd say it's going just goddamn swimmingly. Get woke, you will go broke, he asserted. Well, I agree with that. I agree with that. And what a lovely portrait right at the bottom there of Fulgrim, in all of his glory in Warhammer 40,000. You know, do not tell me that they put that there by accident. So, you know, it is in the early stages of monetizing its IP. Me and Arch do not agree on many things, politics being one of them. And the way to run your Discord server being another. I've got some great people who helped me out with that, and been you know, helped me with certain things that started to resemble an Arch Discord that I didn't like. But we're slowly getting there in turning. Well, not even turning. It's a fantastic place to be honest with you, the Discord. And you know, come and join it, because the more positivity we can get into this hobby, the better at the moment. But as Games Workshop, it is in the early stages of monetizing its IP. I agree with him on that one completely. It is a company that is trying to be Marvel. It is trying to turn itself into tabletop Disney. All right? And that means that people like me and you have to go. Have to go. But I think you've seen up here that we're not going to go quietly. Okay? If they're going to get rid of us, their company is going to fucking tank. And I just hope that the bucket isn't dry by the time they realise. That's my opinion on the Games Workshop stock price conundrum that's been going on. I really hope that you enjoyed the video. And as per usual, I want to thank each and every single one of you for being involved with me, for listening to me rant, and for watching my videos, and to making sure that you know, I'm keeping the lights on. Not that this is my job or anything, but I'd like it to be one day. You never know. Things keep going the way that they are. I don't see any reason why, you know, I can't start doing this full time and running events and entertaining you for a living. That's the dream. That's the dream. And slowly but surely, maybe I can make it happen, but we'll see. We'll see. Thank you very much for watching, guys. It's been a pleasure talking to you. I hope you have a wonderful week. We are on the last week before Christmas holidays and schools, thankful. And I'm planning on doing a lot more content over Christmas. So thank you very, very, very much for watching. Have a wonderful evening. Have a great week. I'll speak to you later on in the week with another video. See you then.